Next is a class from the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 2nd chapter, text number 22, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 25th, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation: therefore, all transcendentalists have been rendering loving service with great delight to Lord Krishna, the Personality of Godhead, from time immemorial, because such devotional service is enlivening to the self.
So, therefore, the word is therefore. Therefore means after concluding something. That is, then you say therefore. When you talk, when you argue, when you come to the conclusion, then you say therefore. Or when our argument is strong, then we say therefore. So this therefore means that one is firmly convinced, as it is described in the previous verse, Vidyate Hridaya Granthi Chiddante Sarva Sangsaya. Sarva Sangsaya. Sangsaya means doubtfulness. Now, this morning we are talking with our scientist friend whether the ultimate source of everything. First of all, the conclusion is that everything is are relatively situated here. Just like some gentleman, that he is son of another gentleman, relative. Then his father is also son of another gentleman. So this world is relative, depending one thing upon another. Nobody is self-independent. This is going on. Then, to find out the original source of everything, that original source, whether it is sentient or insentient. But the conclusion is the original source must be sentient, because in this our experience, experimental knowledge, we see something matter and something living. I am saying, here is a small ant and here is a big stone. The big stone is insentient. It cannot move. For millions of years you wait whether the stone will move. You cannot see, no, it will not move, because it is insentient. Whereas a small ant, it is going, you just check its marching, it will struggle, this way. And ultimately you have to give way. This is sentient. Therefore, sentient is superior. There are two things within our experience. One, matter, not sentient, and another, sentient. So, now I am seer, or sometimes I control both these things. But I am not supreme controller. But I can observe that there are two things, sentient and insentient, and I am observing. So, for the time being, I am superior of both the sentient and non-sentient. So the conclusion is, the ultimate source of everything, ultimate knower, ultimate analyzer, must be a sentient. It cannot be insentient. That is experimental knowledge. So in this way, this our Krishna consciousness movement, Bhagavad Dharma, it is not sentiment. We can explain how God created. Sometimes it is, in Bible it is said, God said, let there be creation, and there was creation. But they cannot explain. Therefore, in the modern age, scientifically advanced, they do not take it. But we can explain. Our Bhagavad Dharma can explain how simply by desiring there is creation. So, here it is a chindanti sarva saṁsaya. Chiddante sarva saṁsaya. What by this, following this Bhagavad Dharma, studying from Bhagavad, the ultimate knowledge of everything, one can become completely doubtless that God is a person, is sentient, is the supreme director, is the supreme knower, is the supreme physicist, is supreme chemist, everything supreme. Just like Krishna lifted the mountain, Girivara Dhari. Jaya Radha Madhava, Kunya Vihari, Gopijana Vallava, Girivara Dhari. When there was torrents of rain, Vrindavan was being overflooded, and all the inhabitants became so much disturbed. They were seeing to, looking to Krishna, because they did not know anything beyond Krishna. Krishna said, yes, I am lifting this mountain. Let it be become a big umbrella of the whole state, or whole village. This atheist will say, these are all stories. No, they are not stories. Because God is supreme. He is supreme physicist. He knows how to make this mountain weightless. He knows the art.